I want to go back to heavenly adoption. I call earthly adoption horizontal between families and heavenly, what God has done for us. If you're a believer with the understanding of the gospel, I would bet that your understanding of the gospel is based primarily on justification, or at least Gary pointed that out when he was going through Habakkuk with us, this verse that was so foundational, that the just shall live by faith. And that was a very, very significant scripture in Martin Luther's life and study, and what really moved him to leave the Catholic Church was his understanding of justification. And it is a critical part of the gospel, and I don't mean to downplay it at all, but let me just talk about it a little bit before I come to a quote. Justification is right legal standing before God. It's foundational to the gospel. I'm going to give you Wayne Grudem's definition. Justification is an instantaneous legal act of God in which he thinks our sins as forgiven and Christ's righteousness as belonging to us and declares us to be righteous in his sight. And that is an important part of our faith. But I want you to look at a quote by J.I. Packer, who we read from earlier. This is also in the same chapter on Sons of God. This free gift, talking about justification, of acquittal and peace won for us at the cost of Calvary is wonderful enough in all conscience, but justification does not of itself imply any intimate or deep relationship with God the judge. In idea, at any rate, you could have the reality of justification without any close fellowship with God resulting. But contrast this now with adoption. Adoption is a family idea conceived in terms of love and viewing God as Father. In adoption, God takes us into his family and fellowship. He establishes us as his children and heirs. Closeness, affection, and generosity are at the heart of the relationship. To be right with God the judge is a great thing, but to be loved and cared for by God the Father is greater. I wanted to pause right here and just ask you to consider for a moment your experience in your relationship with God. Is it defined by a deep sense of belonging to God's family, fellowship as his child? Is your experience one of closeness and affection and the generosity of your Father? Or is it, on the other hand, characterized by fear of God's rejection, or shame that you don't measure up, or pressure to try and measure up, or maybe even doubt as to the love that he has for you in the first place? If the latter is your experience, then I really want to encourage one of two responses. The first is to really ask the question, are you a believer? Because as we saw from the beginning of Ephesus, anyone who has placed their faith in Christ, this is true. They've been adopted. So either the first possibility is maybe this is a move that you need to make to accept Jesus Christ as Savior and receive that justification that he offers and enter into this relationship with him as Father and you as a son or daughter. The other possibility, if your experience isn't the generosity and the closeness and affection, I would just encourage you, meditate on this truth. And I made up cards because I think this is a wonderful truth to have in our lives. I'm going to just have you guys hand them out for me. And just on the one side, I have the verse about that he chose us, and just kind of pick the middle section there. Put it in your Bible, put it on the fridge. You need to know that, and you need to believe it with all of your heart. And on the other side, I put the prayer that I prayed from, which comes in Ephesians right after this passage. And I just put it in first person. And I encourage you, if you're having a hard time with the truth on this side, turn it over and just pray. Pray the scriptures, because God will reveal that this is who he is and this is who you are. He wants us to understand that. And so I encourage you just to commit it to prayer over and over, and I believe that he will give you that assurance and that experience as a believer, as one of his sons. I want to look ahead here. And these words, why he chose us, that we should be holy and blameless before him, are indeed words of justification. Part of the reason that God chose us was to make us holy and blameless. And he did that positionally through the death of Christ. He sees us as made holy and righteous, as worthy to be his son. And what I want to consider now is that adoptions can be extremely costly. If you have anybody that you know of that has adopted, it is extremely expensive to adopt a child into your family. And yet anybody who's gone through that would say there is no cost too high for this child that is now mine. And obviously there is no adoption more costly than our adoption by God. And that's where the gospel really comes in, is the price that was paid to make all of this true about us. And it's in there. It comes up next. But I just want to refer real quick before we jump there. Just the scriptures are so full of the truth of what Christ did for us. And that's the gospel. And I'm committed here at Trinity to rallying around that. And every week in our worship services, this is a central part of who we are. It's what makes us God's family. It's what unites us together. So we celebrate the gospel. All have sinned and fall short of the glory of God and are justified freely by his grace through the redemption that came by Jesus Christ, from Romans 3:23. And so we see these wonderful, wonderful words. And we've been focusing on God the Father, and now I want to focus on God, our Savior, Jesus Christ, and his role in our adoption. The amazing part of the gospel is what we're going to look at now. Verses 7 and 8 says that in him we have redemption through his blood, the forgiveness of sins in accordance with the riches of God's grace that he lavished on us with all wisdom and understanding. And there you have the price that was paid to bring you in and make us and make you his son or daughter. So I want to just pause here. I want to read a couple scriptures that just celebrate this, and I actually do want to celebrate it together. I'm thinking of time here, too, so it's kind of going quickly. Let's read this together. This is from Ephesians. Sharon took us there this morning in our worship time. It's wonderful, wonderful truth. Together, let's go. But because of his great love for us, God, who is rich in mercy, made us alive with Christ, even when we were dead in our transgressions. It is by grace you have been saved. And God raised us up with Christ. He seated us with him in the heavenly realms in Christ Jesus, in order that in the coming ages he might show the incomparable riches of his grace, expressed in his kindness to us in Christ Jesus. Do you see some adoption language there? Being raised up with Christ and seated with him in the heavenly realms. It's kind of a, I picture the mansion, you know, that God is preparing a place for us, that it's been his purpose from all eternity to bring us into that relationship. Incomparable riches of his grace. Did he have what it took to pay that price so you and I could be adopted? The answer is yes.